in most states, but for many parents, the task of keeping kids entertained every day of the week is a pretty daunting one. So just how do you keep organised and sane during the school break? It's today's Daily Dilemma, and here to talk us through it is Margaret Rafferty from KidsPot. Some great tips you're going to run us through, Margaret.
I have.
Shoot.
And I'll be quick. So the first is, if you haven't done this already, you might be in trouble, but really you should be getting a look at what your after-school care program, or OOSH, out-of-school hours program is for the different days of the holidays. Negotiate it with your kids so you don't accidentally send them to something they hate and they'll never go again. the second thing is get on the phone to what I like to call sparents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, the people
Good old grandma.
Yeah.
There she is again.
Bribery might be important for some, but just see if they can
paying them.
Paying them in
good idea.
In practice, whatever.
The kids or the grandmas.
Yeah. Both, whatever it takes. You've just got to find someone to look after them. The third is have a look at our school planner. We've got a great planner on the site so you can organise it, put it on the fridge, email it to people, and everyone knows who's got to be when and where, so that it's all as organised as term time. The fourth one is about making sure you've got your screen time rules going, because it's going to come up. You've got to get it set at the start of the holiday so you can say, I refer you to rule 7A, clause B. You've got to share with your brother or sister. Yeah. So that's an important one.
No policy on the run.
No policy on the run. It doesn't work. The fifth one is do a grocery shop. So it's always fun to get the kids to be a little bit independent, and this is the opportunity to give them some stuff that they're not allowed during term time. You know, it's a treat.
Cocoa Pops, we get the little
Cocoa
packets.
Pops. Oh, yeah. Who doesn't love a bit of sugary holiday time cereal?
So ply them with sugar to keep you sane.
Just a little bit.
Just to relax the rules somewhat. Yeah.
This was very simple. We said have stuff in the pantry or in the fridge that they can just go and get themselves and just do it. Because my cousin has four kids and they're just running around like all tomorrow. And I'm going, how do you do it? How do you ever manage to get any rest? And she said, I taught them how to make toast.
It's essential. So, give them some snacks that they can serve themselves so you're not at their beck and call constantly. Number six would be to organise a play date with and a swap with friends. So ring your girlfriend and say, look, I'll have your two kids for a day if you take mine for a day. And then the kids love it because they get to go and play at someone else's house with other people's toys, which they always love.
It's always better at someone else's house.
It's always better. And plus, you get a day free. Yay! That's a win-win. So that's the seventh. And the seventh one is create an artsy-fartsy corner. So just say if they're bored and, you know, really, when the kids come and say, I'm bored, think, I'm the lady standing at the dish full of dishes. I'm not the best person to ask about how to have a good time. At least you can refer them to the arts corner.
I love you. That's so right.
Go and send them off to the arts corner and say, look, go and draw
have
something,
colour in,
glue something, keep the glitter contained, but go for it.
Yeah.
Great advice.
My mum used to say, go outside and play.
Exactly.
That always works as well. Yeah. Exactly. Margaret Rafferty, thank you very much for coming in.